Now, if you look beyond this gannet, you'll see the state bird of Louisiana. That is the brown pelican, and they are our species feature this week on the Wild Side. We're back here in Port Aransas, Texas, at the Amos Rehabilitation Keep. You can call it the Ark. And it's operated by the University of Texas Marine Science Institute. Before we tell you all about brown pelicans, I have to thank all of our subscribers here on YouTube for following our channel. Leave us comments and questions about this species for this week, and we'll send them straight to the Ark or answer them ourselves just for you. And as always, share our videos with all of your family and friends, and find the Wild Side with Clay on all of your social media. But let's dive like a brown pelican into some fun facts about this amazing species from North America this week on the Wild Side. Behind me is the brown pelican, and we're inside of a rehabilitation facility. These animals are either set to be released or are being evaluated for their release, whether they're good candidates or not. Now, a brown pelican can weigh, on average, about 16 pounds. Now, of course, just like people, there are some heavy birds and some thin birds, but that's a good average. With a 16-pound average, they have a wingspan of approximately 6 feet wide. That's even longer than I am tall. I'm average, all right? I'm like 5'10". They've only got 2 inches on me, okay, folks? Now, the brown pelican is an animal that can be found on the west coast of the United States, but also right here in the Gulf of Mexico. From the southern tips of Texas all the way around the Horn of Florida and up until about South Carolina. Now, if you visit any of your coastlines this summer and see this bird, you'll often see them gliding across that wonderful surf looking for food. You see, what the brown pelican does is it kind of hovers above the surf line, glancing down, looking for schooling fish. And from about 30 feet in the air, it plummets, bill first, boom, right into a school of fish, like millet or menhaden. And they scoop up a vast amount of food in their goulard pouch. Now, we can say goulard a lot on the show. How about we just call it their face bag? It looks like a handbag hanging from their throat. And they hold those fish in there with the water, and they can either fly over to the coastline and start to digest. They'll also crack their bill ever so slightly, because gulls, laughing gulls, different seabirds would love to steal a fish flopping out of that goulard pouch. So they crack their bill just ever so slightly to begin expelling the water before digesting those fish. Now, right on the tip of that bill, you'll notice a very, very sharp hook. That helps them to immobilize their prey, but can also help them to defend themselves against their predators. Now, what on earth would eat a 16-pound shoreline bird like this? Well, there are a couple things. Cats that find themselves homes here on the Gulf Coast, like a bobcat. If they're floating in the water, a tiger shark would love to take a bite out of a brown pelican. They can also, as a chick, be vulnerable to basically everything larger than them in search of a meaty meal. So these animals have to have some pretty big defenses as they age and as they get larger. Now, I know they look weird. They've got that weird face. Their name, pelican, actually translates in Latin to axe face, because when their mouth is full, it does look like they have an axe hanging from their throat. Now, with all of that food in their mouth and their digestion, why would they need to gulp up so much food at a time? I mean, just this gannet alone would probably take one fish and swallow it, move on, one fish and swallow it. Why so many fish? Well, it could be seasonal, but it also could be because they need to take their fish back to their babies. They can have 1 to 3 chicks in a clutch, and they regurgitate that food to the babies. Now, if you've never seen a baby pelican, take a look at this picture. They look weird. When they're born, they're basically naked, and they have little tiny pin feathers, and then those feathers are surrounded by this chick down, this fluff, and they nest on sandy islands, on shrubs, about 2 feet off the ground, so that they can be avoid the tide as it comes in and out. They can also avoid predators that are coming in on that shoreline to get a baby pelican. Now, they're fairly defenseless until they begin to fledge. And what does fledge mean? Well, that means they lose that chick down. They grow in those adult feathers and they start to learn to fly. Have you ever seen a pelican try to fly? It doesn't look like the most graceful. They start to run. They get the gallop going. Their wings come out. And then they take off into the sky. But I'll tell you something. As a native Texan and someone who loves to visit the Gulf Coast, I find nothing more spectacular while visiting the beach than a group of 20 pelican, brown pelican, flying over your head. They're so gorgeous. They're so large. And they are truly majestic. And in the United States, we are lucky enough to not only have one species of pelican, but to have two. The white pelican also calls the United States home. However, unlike the brown pelican, who nests on the coastlines on these sandy beaches, the white pelican tends to fly inland. I know of a nesting pair in Abilene, Texas right now, and that's about 7 hours from our current location. They fly that far inland in freshwater areas to lay their eggs. Now, this animal is an incredible species, and I'm honored to be sharing the brown pelican with you. But they do need your help. And to talk to you a little bit more about their conservation and their rescue, I want to bring in my dear friend who works right here at ARC. So let's take a walk on the wild side over to meet my friend, Alicia Walker. So, of course, we've been talking about pelicans this entire time, but I wanted to introduce you finally to one of the main reasons we are here, and this is Alicia. She is from the ARC, the Amos Rehabilitation Keep. And Alicia, I can't thank you all enough for University of Texas and Marine Science Institute, you guys inviting us into your home. But I wanted to give you a moment to tell a little bit about your rescue here of the brown pelican. How many brown pelicans would you say you rescue a year?
We rescue about 50 to 100 brown pelicans a year. They're the most common bird that we see here.
And gorgeous animals. Now, for what reason would an animal like this need to be rescued?
Yeah, so we find them a lot of times wrapped up in fishing line, entangled. And then also sometimes we find them with pouch tears from them eating the wrong kind of food, like hardhead catfish, that fishermen are feeding them.
Because their gular pouch isn't prepared to take those kind of fish.
They're
mainly looking for the other schooling fish.
Yeah.
So you suture them up?
Yeah, our veterinarians help to suture them up. Yeah.
And then the big day, what does the release look like for these animals?
It's amazing. It's the best part of the job, really. And so we'll take them out to the location that they were found, really close by usually. And then we just let them go when they're ready and they fly off.
Now, there are certain criteria I'm sure the pelican has to hit before it can get that. And outside of punctures, there's also entanglement. And a lot of fishermen, a lot of people here in Corpus Christi and Port Aransas, Aransas Pass, they watch this channel. How can we make sure that we have less entanglement rescues needed here in the Gulf Coast?
Yeah, we can all pitch in to, when you're out there in the environment, just pick up. If you see something out there, just pick it up and dispose of it.
Don't trash where you splash. Let the animals have their environment. Keep the oceans and the coastline so much better than you left it. And because of that, this organization will have less rescues to do, but they are amazing at what they do. They are a nonprofit. They could use your help. Head over to their Facebook page. The link is in our bio. Give them a like. Follow their rescues. Follow their live releases. They do turtle releases on there live on Facebook. She's always on that social media channel doing her thing with the sea turtles. And look for more from us and ARC here in the future. But for now, signing off from the Amos Rehabilitation Keep, the legacy of Tony Amos lives right here in Port Aransas. I'm Clay. This is Alicia. Thanks for walking on the wild side of brown pelicans. Conservation rules. And we'll see you next week when we highlight yet another of your favorite species. Until then, give them a like. Bye, everybody.